Welcome to Foss North, the virtual edition. We would like to thank all our sponsors and partners in this difficult situation. Our gold sponsors, Luxoft and Ansible by Red Hat. Our silver sponsors, ITRS Group and Make It Right. Our base sponsors. Our partner projects, the open source community and the region of Gothenburg. And a huge thanks to our awesome community. This would not have been possible without you.
Okay, so hi, I'm Ron Munitz. I'm from the PSCG, which is a training consulting company. We do all kinds of things, mostly cybersecurity, embedded and mobile. We do a lot of the things that are the interest of Chris as well, that is Android internals, macOS internals, and Yocto and the likes. And the reason I'm sharing is because on my Twitter, actually, you have this particular document that gives you some links to the references. In this quick talk, I'm going to give you a very, very, very brief intro to quick starting the Yocto project, which is pretty much a de facto way to build embedded Linux systems, but not only Linux these days. And the problem with it, why I think that it requires some introduction, is that if you're like a first timer, setting up an environment and actually playing with it for the first time, just like with the Android open source project, takes a lot of time and a lot of resources. So I'm going to show in like 5 minutes how to actually get it set up on AWS or on any cloud provider, how to build a first platform that is like an emulator that you can boot. And I actually made a little longer video that I have a link for that shows like the entire process and discusses some of the caveats. So here it goes. So in order to actually get started with the Yocto project and build like a nice emulator, we need to do several things. We'll go to the Yocto project website, and then over there, we're going to go and actually, there are several documents and the documentation is very, very, very important. So the get started here is super recommended, but if you're already experienced, it tells you, hey, experienced, get the code. And there is like the relevant platform version, distro version that is called Pocky that has revisions and the current revision is Zeus. So you can either take it with Git or copy and do wget to it, which is what I have done. In addition to it, you have all kind of what is known as layer, that is to support building things yourself or reusing components of others. Very important layers are BSP, for example. And when you actually go and wget this Yocto project, what you get, just like in any other embedded system, is something that looks like this. So we're going to have all kinds of files. And if you just look at it, it's something that's supposed to build like a lot of different Linux system potentially, then you'll see that it's not so big, right? It's going to be like 59 or 60 megs. How do these files look? I will show a very simple recipe, which is some sort of metadata a little bit later. But these files are actually mostly all kind of textual files and the build system itself, which is a combination of Bitbake, which is the build tool built in Python and Bash, and Open Embedded, which is the base for the Yocto project and its so-called reference distro that is known as Pocky. You will, if you deal with Yocto, you will hear all these names and a lot of time you don't know like what is what. So I'm just letting you get used to the terms. Then you will see that there are really all kind of textual files. So just let's go, for example, to select something random. Meta is the synonym for open embedded core. And what we see, just for example, I'm just selecting at random, we have like under recipes kernel, the ways to, for example, build the device T compiler or the K mode for inserting mode probing and so on. And there is also like the script, for example, and there are all kinds of tools and so on. And just to look like what a Linux kernel build method looks like in the Yocto project, we can see that all of these guys are files. Let's select one at random. Let's take, for example, this Linux Yocto. 5.2bb. And we see there that it is a textual file with a lot of definition. It's not going to be a YAML, it's not going to be a JSON. It's going to have its own syntax, where some of the things that can stand out are things like SRC URI that tells us where to actually get the source code from. So in this case, it's using the Git protocol, and it's going to take it like from a particular branch and so on. There are a lot of things that I don't have time to explain, so I'll not say. It will tell kind of dependencies, and it will also have things that will say, for example, hey, if you want to build like the kernel for, let's say, QEMU ARM, then you're going to use this particular commit. So there is a way to actually specify metadata that on top the build system is going to like act and behave. So when you see BP, it's going to be, it represents bitbake, and a lot of time we'll see bitbake append that is going to be BB append. Now, these are textual files. What do you get when you actually want to actually build a system and do something with it? So you're going, after setting up the system as per the instructions in the Yocto quick build quick start guide that is over the main page as well. And you're going to actually see that you start everything by sourcing these scripts, OE init build env, that as per itself, it's a bash script that checks all kinds of things and then calls OE build env internal. So if you want to actually go ahead and do something that is start something, you're going to source OE init build env and then have some folder that is going to be your output folder. For example, blah. When you do this, then you're going to have all kinds of nodes like common target R, core image minima, which enables you to build a busybox-based minimal Linux distro. There's going to be core image status, this graphical. There's going to be a bunch of others. And you're going to have like, hey, you had no conf local conf file, so something has been generated for you. So when I just do this, not much happens. I have the following structure. One of them is going to be conf bb layers that tells me, it refers back to the tarball or git that I extracted and tells me, hey, these are like the layers that you have. So here by default, I will always have meta, poki, meta yocto bsp. And if you actually use something else, let's say if you build like for the Raspberry Pi, you're going to have another bsp layer probably. Okay. Layer is also like a nice way to organize your code and your stuff. But in order to get really, really, really quickly started, the most important file is conf local conf that tells you, for example, what machine you're going to build for. For example, if you want to build for the BeagleBone Black, then it's going to be this guy. In this case, the default is going to be QEMU x86-64, where this syntax means, hey, if this doesn't exist, override it, set it. If it exists, don't touch it. So there are a lot of things that I'm not going to talk about too much, but two very important parameters are DLDR, which is where you're going to download your packages, your tarballs, extract from Git, and estate cachedir, which is going to make builds very, very, very fast for you. Why am I mentioning it? Because if you start and just do what the instruction tell you and do bitbake with the target, which is, for example, core image minimal, then it will take a lot of time. An entire build is going to be something like, let's see what we have here, this first one that I made, something like 40 gigs, like altogether. Okay, so I'm not going to actually do that. In the longer video, I actually show it, but I'm going to see how we reuse it and do something like nice and simple. Okay, so in this case, which is what I present in the GitHub, I have this simple script that does the following. We do the source OE build env into a directory that is called live. I had a pre-made conf and a layer that I don't know if I'll have time to present, but if I do, then I'll show some nice thing up to organize and add your own code. And after this, I actually go ahead, after I source the directory will be changed, I do bitbake core image minimal. And once it's done, it's going to be run QEMU, no graphic. So since I have a pretty strong machine here, I'm going to do here like this return, it already exists, then it will take like 1 minute. But otherwise, it will take you forever, okay? So if you want to start and play with things, you would want to go ahead and look at like the sort of caching or recipes that I did, where now I'm just going to let it build. And what I add there, like, would be this, like under conf, I actually went and referred it to a directory that I already populated packages into it. And same thing for estate cache dir, which actually presenting. I know I'm not explaining it completely. I explain it more in the video and of course in the courses. So now the build system looks like this. It's going to have phases like fetch the packages, unpack in order to extract. It's going to have a configure, what you'd expect like in automate, and compile, all kind of packaging RPMs. And at the end, it's going to actually go ahead and repackage your rootfs, and you'll have all the results under your build directory, eventually, under TMP, which is like the working directory for everything, and deploy. So if you build like a real target, you can flash from there. So the next step here, because it's like an emulator, I just going to have, there are all kind of shortcut scripts, run QMU. And this particular nice thing here allows me like to run here the kernel. I ran it without graphics so that it will be like in the same terminal. There are all kind of annoying caveats with that where you don't do it in a graphic. And if I actually go and let it run, then I see that I have a root. I see that, for example, under user bin, well, under user bin, I will have a lot of links that pretty much indicated this is a BusyBox-based distro. And I also made like a one, like a, an executable that I added. This is the other GitHub repository that I hope I still have time like to show, that this guy is like a demo application that if you give it like a beer, it says something good about the beer. And if you give it like virus, it says something bad about the virus, okay? So how did I do it? In order to exit it, I'm going to do control I
X. We're running out of time here.
Okay, so we'll finish it. I'll just say one little thing, that in the links that I put there, it's like on my Twitter, you're going to have this guy, which is a layer. And this layer actually shows like how I actually fetched the code from another GitHub repository. And the recipe for it is going to be 20 seconds. It's like very, very, very simple. Like it's going to be a couple of lines, just stating where to take the source code from and what protocol. It's going to tell the revision that I want to check out. And it's going to say all kind of other metadata licenses are always very important in open source projects. And in Erit Auto Tools means that it's an autoconf project. So that's it for now. And if there are like any questions, I'd be happy to further discuss them.
Thank you so far. There is a question here. So compared to an ordinary distro, how much is packaged in Yocto? And how likely are you to have to package the stuff yourself?
How likely? Okay, so the question is comparing to other distro, how likely you are to packet to create packages yourself?
Yep.
So the truth is that very, very, very likely. First of all, the Yocto project, one of the things that it does is one of the states is in addition to like fetching and downloading and unpacking, is actually going to take whatever you build and package it in well-known format. For example, you can package in like RPM, for instance. So it's done usually automatically as part of the build procedure, and it's always done. You always prepare packages. Now it's like it's part of the routine. When you work like with Debian or with RPM, then usually you are not going to do it yourself unless you want to actually distribute the package. When you build a Yocto project-based distro, then it's just an integral part of the procedure. So you are very, very, very likely to do that. And it's also very easy. You just need to understand like the language of how to write metadata, that is recipes, classes, and so on. And then it's like easier.